These are the muscles for straight legs in Chaturanga, the quadriceps. They straighten the leg, but that one quad also crosses the hip joint. And then we need to engage the hamstrings and the gluteus maximus muscles to find that hip extension to balance out the legs being straight in Chaturanga.
Why it's important for us to find that engagement of the legs in Chaturanga, especially that hip extension, is because we move from Chaturanga into a back bend, into upward facing dog, and you need that extension of the hip joint so it doesn't go into the low back.
When you're on your knees in Chaturanga, shift the weight forward, go all the way down to the ground, and then come to a cobra pose. Keep it small, cobra. That'll build you the strength for upward facing dog, but also have you feel what it's like to really keep that posterior tilt of the pelvis when you're in a back bend.
So once you've determined that you can lower into Chaturanga with straight legs and you've got the quadriceps and the hamstrings and glutes, that hip extension working, you bend the elbows, you still shift the weight forward in space, you hover, the shoulders do not pass the elbows.
Here, Angela demonstrates how she goes from plank to Chaturanga Dandasana. You'll notice that her elbow angle is very different than mine because, as we just want to remind you, proportions matter in this pose, every pose, but really this pose. Just showing how she gets into Chaturanga to up dog. Notice how she flips her feet one at a time. She does this to protect her sacroiliac joint. Her sacroiliac joint likes to move around a little bit too much. Plus, she's able to really get onto the tops of the feet, press down, and not roll to the outer ankle.
A few times I do Chaturanga to up dog because I've retired this pretty much from my practice. I go down to Chaturanga, I slide back, and then pull myself through to upward dog. So I push the toes back, and I come onto the tops of the feet.
We see a couple of things with the feet in this tricky transitions. One is that when you start to roll down, see how I shear to the outer feet? And I carry that with me that way. We call that the ankle swoosh. It's bad.